completely 100% aware of everything. I mean, kids know everything. We know more than the adults, you know, because we know all the angles. We've got all the angles. We're getting all the views of who said what. We know everything. In a situation looking at these home movies where the kids are everywhere. So we knew who was having an affair with who and when and what. And we didn't think much of it, though. I mean, why would you? We were just, it's just what was going on. It's my dad giving me a haircut. I don't like it, apparently. And there's Gerty in the, I love that shot, Gerty in the reflection, filming Mirka with a candle. I'm not sure what that means, what they were doing. They were all very liberated people, really. You know, they'd just been through so much. It was just great to have some fun. You can see they're in their, they weren't in a bubble. They weren't in a bubble, but they were hanging out with like-minded people. I mean, all the artists were hanging out with artists. Now, this is a big one. This is, there's George. And when I saw this, I just couldn't believe that was Melvyn Douglas. I just wound it back. And what the hell is Melvyn Douglas, star of Ninotchka, doing there? That's a painter called Charles somebody. And Mirka, of course, outside the bloody banister. Like, really good example to the kids, right? It was a really good idea. And Laurence Hope. And it turned out Melvyn Douglas, that's Grace Smith. This is the whole gang, actually, I think, this film. That looks like Willie. But Melvyn Douglas had been in a play across the street from the Mirka Cafe. That's Mary Perceval, now Lady Nolan. There's Mum. And there's Melvyn Douglas, star of Ninotchka and Hud, and being there. So he was there because he was, I guess he got out of Hollywood because of the blacklist, and he was in Melbourne for quite a while doing a Noel Coward play, went to the Mirka Cafe and loved everybody, loved my parents, and we all became close friends. And now that's, the cigar is Arthur Boyd, and to his left is Joy Hester, and to his right was a sculptor called Julius Kane. That guy, Julius Kane. A really good sculptor. I don't know what his reputation is now, but he was fantastic. And now, she was a dancer with an American ballet company. I'm not quite sure what the company was, but they were touring. And of course, you know, the Bohemians, of course the black dancers can come to our, they invite them to come to the meet Melvyn Douglas. I remember this guy's, remember him very well. And that's David Boyd. He was a fantastic personality. You can see he's charismatic there. That's Mandy. That's Hermia's daughter. There's John Percival here, and there's a really funny penis drawing he does here coming up, which I just couldn't believe it when I saw her. There was a lot of sex jokes and humor about it. You know, because this is a flower. It was always, you know, Mirka would always say things like, and they always, oh, a beautiful penis, you know, a beautiful breast. Everything was beautiful.